you today?
Hello again, everybody.
Oh, Harry. Oh, yeah, Harry.
You know, there comes a time when you probably ought to stop broadcasting. I probably should have quit about 5 years before I passed.
Yeah. I think we should have quit about 20 years ago.
That's okay. I've been listening since 10. Mm-hmm. I can't make anything out of it.
What am I, God, what do I know?
We only deal in truth. Here.
Oh, my God. What world am I living in? Scott Barker's making me laugh.
Don't you feel a little stupid? Go over there this afternoon. Throw your worm in the water and see how that works out.
Throw your worm in the water means something different in Los Angeles.
Well, it means about the same thing here in Kenosha.
Wow.
Things haven't changed.
That's what I'm saying. I can't make heads or tails. Which part is which?
Was a virgin sacrificed?
Not that I recall. We couldn't find one.
And not in Kenosha anyway, right?
Get through what you got to get through, Scott.
This program is a real challenge.
Good morning, everybody. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 9th Valentine's edition of the award-winning Kenosha Today Weekly Report. Coming to you live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WLIP. We are streaming live and booming across the cold and crisp cornfields of the Midwest, reaching out to over 1.4 million listeners residing here in the Tri-County area. Being brought to you this morning by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of other very fine local businesses. With us this morning, a little Cupid's personal advisor, the Greek god of love, Elmo Snyder, joins us here in the Enchanted Kingdom this morning. The Greek god of love. You look a little Greekish.
Let's not go there.
Trying to build up the act, and already he's turning, shunning me away.
Geekish.
Also with us, my boyhood hero, our video coordinator, wearing a heart on his sleeve, Spider Ronnie the Love Doctor, joins us here at Camp Happy Face. Spider.
Good morning, everybody.
You see the trend here? It's going to be a Valentine's special.
Oh, I'm so excited.
I thought it was anti-Valentine's.
Well, we're going to get to that. Engineering and board operating the Kenosha Today Love Trolley this morning. The Kissing Bandit. See, I didn't leave you out.
Oh, thank you.
Wacky Wayne is
here. So glad I could be included.
Wacky Wayne is here with all my children. This week, the Kenosha Today Secret Word Challenge is sponsored by Barter's Financial Planning Services. And the Kenosha Today Brain Trust has pre-selected this morning's secret word. And the first caller to say that will win a $20 Boathouse gift card. And actually, somebody won. Tim from Lake Bluff won last week.
Yeah.
And I got to catch up to him one of these days and pay him off.
Right.
And there was a late substitute that Elmo substituted. That's why he won. But now I'm back to my original.
From last week.
From last week.
Spelled correctly. Yeah.
Well, how could I go wrong?
Right. In theory.
In theory. Coming up after the 10:30 weather break, Kenosha's fastest growing game show sensation, the Lightning Round of City in Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And, you know, going back to the Brain Trust, we had a heck of a production meeting.
Oh, really?
Yesterday afternoon.
Oh, yeah.
And you can tell things are maybe have a tendency to slide when my three grandkids and my daughter start attending these and saying, hey, they're having a good time.
Wow.
I mean, that the old apples don't fall too far from the tree, you know.
Nope. You paid them off, huh?
Training them well.
Yeah.
You know, my granddaughter, she's taken this accounting, and she's a sophomore.
Okay.
And she's trying to learn how to balance a checking account.
Sure.
And she was 19 cents off.
Yeah.
And I says, well, you just take the white out. You just, that's how you balance it out.
Oh, boy.
I says, all that stuff you learn in school, forget the teacher.
Forget
it. You come and listen. This is where you get an education.
You come hang out with Uncle Scotty.
Yeah. I remember, as long as we're on that, there was a guy that was bartending. He was going to Parkside taking finance and business management.
Sure.
And he was saying, he'd come down to our little corner,
yeah,
and he listened to us over, you know, a number of months. He goes, you know, what you guys are talking about, they don't cover that stuff at Parkside.
Right, yeah.
And so I see him about 6 months after he gets a job at a bank.
Sure.
And he says, yeah, you guys are pretty much right on. I says, well, you didn't waste all your 4 years of education. I mean, you chased some girls, right? I mean, you had to have something to show for it all.
12 years of college down the drain.
Yeah. It's like your 18,000 you spent at broadcasting school.
Yeah.
See, you didn't learn none of this. This is on-the-job training right here.
Because you do a lot of training on that side of the board there, buddy.
Yep.
Learn all sorts of stuff from you.
Can you believe this? The other day, Elmo called me a lousy speller. I was offended.
Your spell check has even quit on you. I mean, come on now.
Yep. Yeah, I don't know how that is. Of course, after the 11 o'clock break, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category written on the deck at the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. Top 10 signs nobody wants to be your Valentine.
Okay.
I mean, you look at me and you can understand, okay, maybe one or two, but there's top 10.
There's a top 10.
Yeah, there is a top 10.
There was a census taken.
But what? I don't know. It was many years of experience.
Okay. All right.
These I didn't have to make up. This is from...
This is all personal experience. These are all true accountings.
Yes.
All right.
Life's... whatever they call it. Also, during that half hour, we're going to be playing a little Stump the Chumps. See if one of our lucky listeners has an opportunity to see if they're actually smarter than the chumps that sit here. We met a new friend at the production meeting.
A new friend, huh?
Chris, his name was, right?
Yep.
And
he said he'd listen today.
Is this Chris's real name?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, well.
I know you know some people that don't go by their real name, so I just wanted to double check.
Well, he didn't say he was wanted in any state, but...
Okay.
Anyway, right. He said he wanted to be a guest here.
Really?
There was one stipulation. Can I...
Talk to Shirley about that.
Yeah. He says, I said, well, what the hell? He says, can I smoke a fat boy before I come on? I said, that's probably the only way you're going
to... Be able to sit through this? Yeah. Through this.
Now, we don't condone that type of behavior, and I assumed he was just joking.
Sure.
He has a lovely wife, Kelly.
Kelly.
And we invited them to be our campus couple on here for our Valentine's
sure.
special, and naturally they declined.
No.
Yeah, and we also invited our friend Bart and his lovely wife of...
Yeah, Bart and Tara.
Of 30-some years, almost 40 years.
Yeah.
And I can't use the language she used when she declined.
Right, yeah. A lot of colorful expletives, yeah, huh? Yeah. All right.
You think... You got problems with the button over there.
Right, yeah. We don't want to go that far.
Jeez, excuse me. I've had this cold all week.
Oh, good. You brought it to work with you then. Thank you.
I didn't go to the boathouse for 3 days.
Oh, but you came here.
Well, I'm better.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
Well.
Awesome. Things to look forward to. Thanks, Scotty.
It's 3:05 on my phone. My text is going, you know, they're ready to send the National Guard out there.
Wow.
I have to bring a note from my doctor.
Yeah, he had to bring a note from his doctor to get back into Amen Corner.
And so I go to my pharmacy. What, right? I had to go to my pharmacy to get some. I just got some over-the-counter cold capsules.
Sure.
I had to show an ID card.
Well, yeah. You got the stuff behind the counter, yeah.
Well...
Don't get the Sudafed, then.
You know, I thought showing my driver's license to get the toilet paper was a little over the top.
Right.
Oh, my God. This is, I'm 69 years old. At least I got to have toilet paper, right?
Well, you know, the cold medicine they've had behind the pharmacy counter for, what, like a decade now?
Yep.
The fact that you haven't needed it in over that long, you know, just shows you don't get sick very often, which good for you, but
yeah,
they're not going to change the rules just because all of a sudden you're sick. And
the only pills I've had to take is for the social disease, but that cleaned that right up. Right.
I told him just pound some Jägermeister. That'll take care of that.
Oh, yeah, that would have put me right out into the harbor. And if you're successful, I talked about that, right? And if there's even more comma, boys and girls, after the 11:30 break, our weekly editorial segment. What is it this week? As the what turns?
Pork belly.
Oh, what?
Pork belly.
I can't remember.
It's the heart.
It's like as the broken heart turns.
As the broken heart turns.
Ah.
You ever had your heart broken? Remember the first girl that ever broke your heart?
Yeah, I don't know.
The last word in lonesome is me.
The last word in lonesome is me. It's hard to believe we couldn't get a female to join us with that.
Yep.
What do you think, Spider or Wacky?
What?
Wayne? There's a red light there.
Oh, I'm not paying attention.
good morning, you're on Kenosha today.
Happy Valentine's Day.
No. Happy Valentine's,
the Greek
Charlotte.
Goddess and everybody else.
What? We've got a Greek goddess here? Elmo, did you get a surgery that I don't know about?
No, not yet.
All right.
Not yet. Shirley, do you know where Valentine's originated?
Its
origins to a Christian effort to replace a pagan fertility festival that has been dated as far back as the 6th century B.C., during the festival, Roman priests would sacrifice goats and dogs and use their blood-soaked hides to slap women on the streets as a fertility blessing. And then, according to legend, women would later put their names in a urinal. Not a urinal, an urn.
An urn. Yeah, 6th century B.C., they got a lot of urinals back then.
Yeah, with the
mess. Right.
Oh, I mispronounced that.
Or misspelled it, one or the other.
They put their names in an urn and be selected to be paired with a man for a year. Now, what's a greater way? What are we missing out, Elmo?
I don't know.
I mean, we missed our calling here. And we should have Gunga call us and see, you know, would sacrifice goats and dogs and blood-soaked
hides. Right, Gunga knows all about that. He has to call.
To slap women on the streets as a fertility blessing. Boy, that seems like a... That's a match made in heaven to me.
I guess so. And, I want Gunga to be my Valentine's Day.
Oh, jeez. Well, you're going to have to get slapped. He's going to have to slap you around a little bit.
With a goat hide.
With a goat hide. And you know what I like about this concept is you get to be paired with a man for only a year. And you can skate. There's no...
lifelong commitment.
Life, and there's no commitment, and there's
right.
no
community
property,
for
1 year.
And
splitting up all the whatever the goats and the dogs' hides are left.
Sure.
You can just walk.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That sounds like a pretty good deal to me.
This was before our time, Elmo.
Of course, then again, if she doesn't like you, she can always poison you, so, you know. Not a lot of penalty for that, you know.
Uh-huh.
And then, of course, there's the romantic tragedy of Romeo and Juliet. You know the first Valentine was written. You know where it was written? And no, it wasn't the Roosevelt.
Manor?
Wasn't the Roosevelt Theater either? No, it certainly wasn't in Barter Manor. The first Valentine was written in a prison. Charles, the Duke of Orleans, wrote a love letter to his second wife at the age of 21. He was captured in some battle of Agincourt. And he was a prisoner for more than 20 years. I don't know if he was a prisoner in the prison or he just stayed with this gal for 20 years. Probably the same thing, right, Elmo?
Yes.
And he would never see his Valentine's reaction. He penned to her in the early 15th century, 20 years at age 21. I don't know what he wrote to her other than, you know, can you come see me at the conjugal visit time?
I mean, somehow I don't think they had that back then.
Conjugal visits?
Yeah, no.
Well, what's the sense of going to prison?
I don't think he had a choice.
I don't know.
And then, of course, you've heard like spiders wearing his heart on his sleeve. And during the Middle Ages, men would draw the names of women that they would be coupled with for the upcoming year while attending a Roman festival. And after choosing, the men wore the names of their on their sleeve to show their bond during the festivities.
You know, is that like, kind of the same thing as throwing the keys in a fishbowl at a party? And
yeah, drinking your way to the bottom.
No. Yeah. No, they would do, the people would do, you know, the guys would throw the keys in a fishbowl and the women would fish them out, and whoever got your keys, that's who you went home with.
So. Boy, I got to tell you what, Elmo, that beats online dating all the hell.
It's not much difference.
It's not much difference. So, anyway, just
thought we... Your girlfriend or whatever for Valentine's Day, any of you, what are you going to buy him?
I buy in bulk. I don't...
4 ounce fillets and rock gut vodka?
Yeah. And I buy only a couple of them because then they got enough for breakfast.
Right, exactly.
And, you know, spending more than $1.99 on a liter of vodka is, you know, that's putting her in
highway
the lap
robbery,
of luxury.
Yeah.
So what did you get your husband for Valentine's Day?
Nothing yet.
Okay, it's coming up. Well, you know, all right, what's the...
I usually bake him something. He likes my pies.
He likes your pie? You know, but Shirley, you can do that anytime. Valentine's, you're supposed to do something special.
Well, at this age, baking a pie, that is something special.
Yeah, it's like the guy that buys his wife a vacuum cleaner. You know, here, nothing, and a scale. Nothing says, I love you more than here, hop on here, baby. And in two years, I'll get you new batteries.
Well, no, he doesn't want flowers or anything like that, so no, he's getting the pie, and he'll be really happy for that.
So what is he getting you?
I have no idea.
A pie. He gets to share.
The crust.
She gets to share the pie with him.
Whatever I tell him I want, he'll get you.
What do you think the proper amount of...
Or go out to dinner.
I'm asking questions here, Shirley. What do you think the amount of proper amount that a husband and wife should spend on each other for Valentine's Day?
Amount they should spend on Valentine's Day?
Yeah, 20, 50, 100?
Probably 25, maybe.
25, okay. So your pie is worth more than 25.
Yeah, it's worth more than that.
Good luck finding a dozen roses for 25 bucks.
Yeah. Well, actually,
Sherry's berries.
I've seen them in Walmart. They have roses for $19.99.
Yeah.
And some of them even have the stems on them.
Right.
That's the thing I saw. What's refined sugar and dead vegetation got to do with love anyway? So
yeah. Hey, Elmo's got a special Valentine's song he wants to sing.
Oh, no,
to.
We'll save that.
You're going to save that? Okay.
Yeah, maybe.
Well, he's going to come up later.
Maybe.
He's going to sing it?
Well, he's possibly thinking
about
it.
I don't know. Yep.
Hey, a couple questions left, and then I'll let you go. Who was your first kiss?
Oh, boy. At the Roosevelt Theater.
I didn't ask where. We want names.
I'm not going to say his name.
Why, is he listening?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
He's probably... All right.
Yeah, I think he's gone.
Yeah. So you remember... and who invented kissing, by the way?
I don't know.
You know, who invented this thing where you put lips together? I mean, what's so good about that? Seriously.
It's obviously been a while since you've done it.
Yeah.
Yeah. For mistletoe, that's good.
That's Christmas.
That's Christmas.
Yeah. I know, but it's good any time. Yeah, that's a good question. Who did invent the first kiss?
Well, according to this, this was a history. This was, again, in early Christianity or across the Middle Ages. A symbol was used to sign off on documents. After making an X, the writer would often kiss the mark as a sign of their oath. And as the gesture grew among kings and commoners to certify books, letters, and paperwork, the records were described as having been sealed with a kiss. Yes. All right, now that I've completely bored everybody.
Boy, aren't you a treasure trove of knowledge this morning.
It's a good thing your crack team of researchers pulled all this up for you.
I had it up here in the memory.
Right. Uh-huh.
All right, Shirley, well, you have a nice day and a nice, not Halloween, a Valentine's
weekend. It's Valentine's Day, yeah. And I want to say hi to Nancy and Dennis. I think they make a very good couple.
Dennis from Waterford?
Valentine's Day or any time.
Oh, she's got him just wrapped around her little finger. You know, it's getting spring season, and he's going to be looking at every mall from Madison to Johnstown to Milwaukee and everything in between, the poor guy.
No, they're a very nice couple. I like them.
Okay.
Good to know.
Good word in for
you.
I'm glad when they call up. They're very funny.
Fun.
Very
they're
nice
fun.
People.
Yeah, they are. All right, Shirley.
Okay,
see you later.
All right. Have a great Valentine's Day, and whoever you kiss, enjoy it.
Yes.
We're celebrating anti-Valentine's Day. In the 15th.
I'm not kissing nobody.
Okay, well, don't. No, find somebody.
I'm saving myself.
For Elmo.
What?
Come here, big boy. Puck her up.
Once Elmo gets that surgery.
All right, we got to go.
Yeah, see you,
okay, special. Thank you. Right. Bye-bye.
Happy bye-bye.
By the way, there's even better news, folks. For those who might have forgotten, tomorrow at noon, each and every Sunday, you can relive the magic here at AM 1050 WLIP. Listen to the replay of this deal. You know, a couple things. And then you can watch the replay of this finely tuned, professionally produced excuse for a radio show on Spectrum's Channel 14 on Tuesdays at 5 p.m. and Wednesdays at 6 p.m. And for you late night owls, you can have a tendency to get overserved on Friday night. The ever-popular 2:30 a.m. Saturday replay is there for the viewing. And you can also sign up with the thousands of our fans and listeners who have joined the Kenosha Today Nation and liked us on Facebook. And like I said, if you feel inclined, you can join us Fridays at 3 p.m. at the Boathouse on the Deck for Getting Silly with Scotty. A couple things going on. Little Anthony Kennedy called in last week, and he was promoting the Kenosha Snow Days Festival starts today at noon in Memorial Park downtown, which is right by City Hall.
Mm-hmm.
And this year's theme is, somebody better help me out. This year's theme is Beach Party, the Downtown Ice Tour is back. Do I have a call there?
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Beach party with snow?
With snow. Good morning, you're in Kenosha today.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm a first-time caller.
Okay.
Congratulations.
What is your name?
My name is Sue, and I'm calling from Ingleside.
Oh, we've talked to you before.
We did?
Yeah.
You did?
Sue from Ingleside. Yeah, I remember you. Okay, Sue, what can we do? What can I do
well, you were asking Shirley. my good friend Shirley. Hi, Shirley. Where she had her first kiss.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, oh, I better call and answer that question about myself.
Okay, where was it, Sue?
In Chicago, where I lived, the apartment where I grew up in. We had kind of a studio, I think you call it, or an English basement.
Mm-hmm.
So we had the sidewalks that were in front of the house. Underneath them used mm-hmm. to be the coal bins many, 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 many moons ago. And so they were all cleaned out. And us kids, we used to play in those old sheds, and we used to take boards out between the houses. We could go not blocks, but houses and houses down the street.
So, Sue, when does the kissing come in?
Oh, because I know. We used to play once in a while, spin the bottle.
Oh, Sue, you tramp, you. Remember that? How old were you, Sue?
I'm going to say 11.
11? And you started...
And it was, you know, years later, Bobby Meinberg told me that, yes, he used to sit up on the kind of a little bit of a hill because the bottle always went pointed down.
Did you get the impression years later that old Bobby was trying to...
Rigging the game.
Rigging
the game. Yes, he was. He was a stinker.
But how, was he a good kisser?
Yeah, he gave a good little kiss.
Did you make him marry you?
No.
Oh, no. Bobby the Stinker Meinberg.
No, because Billy Dugan was there in that show.
So you're doing a three-way with Bobby and Billy?
Yeah, well, we had to take turns.
Oh, wow. Sue, I got to give you credit for calling up. This is what you call first-time caller, last-time listener, I can tell you right now. Billy Stoneberg and Bobby Meinberg with Sue from Ingleside.
Billy Dugan,
yeah. Oh, those are all rubbish. Was there another guy involved here?
No, I only remember though we were on the same block.
Did you
for Jeanette? Yeah.
So did you ever come to the realization that these two characters were probably fixing the game?
No, I never did. It wasn't until we were adults, because we grew up being friends, and my brother actually, he had was friends with what? Because we were close in age, so we all hung out together.
What kind of bottle was it?
Who cares?
So if Billy or Bobby call in, and I ask them, was Sue from Ingleside a good kisser? What do you think they're going to say?
Well, they better say okay, because I'll have to go smack on one.
You're burying your soul here.
I'm wondering, were there any goats involved in this ritual?
Yeah.
No. Oh, we used to terrorize the neighborhood. We used to climb up lampposts and buildings. And at one time, the store Weebles, you guys probably don't know Weebles.
I remember Weebles.
Well, they tore down a whole block of buildings. But before they tore them down, we used to go hang out in them. And we used to take boards and put them from one window, the building of one, and to the next one. And we used to go through them. Oh, my God, was that fun.
What year was this, in the 50s?
Yes.
Well, Sue the Kissing Bandit from Ingleside,
yep.
You know, I applaud you for bearing your soul, and to the message go forth to Bobby Meinberg and Billy Dugan, give us a call. We'd like to 262-694-1050. We got to...
Well, you guys have a nice Valentine's Day. Take your wives to Chicago, find an empty building,
wives?
And crawl under it.
Crawl
under it.
First of all, we're not married. Are you married, Sue?
Yes.
Okay, how long have you been married?
47 years.
Wow. What's the key to that? No kissing.
you get a little deaf. I had four kids, and I always tell young parents, don't worry. Every time you have a kid, you lose some of your brains and your hearing.
Four kids. Along with that. That's Planned Parenthood at its best, right? Well, what are you going to get your husband of 47 years for Valentine's Day?
I won't nag him.
You won't nag him?
The greatest gift you
one
can give.
One day a year.
That says a year. That says, well, I love you more than anything, sweetheart. I'm not going to nag you for 24 hours. All right.
Have a good Valentine. Whatever you do.
Thanks, Sue. Bye-bye.
Sue the Kissing Bandit.
In the coal bins under the homes down in Chicago.
With Bobby and Billy. Billy Dugan and Bobby Meinberg. Wow.
I think I know those guys. They owe me money.
Yeah. I gotta read a
it's almost sponsor. Time for the weather.
Almost time for the weather, yeah.
Downhill.
Are you in Florida? Or are you in home?
I am. I saw I'm calling because I saw our good friend Daryl the other day.
Down on his yacht.
Well, I saw a silhouette of him. Okay, we went to go make some reservations to go fishing, and there's only one spot for a 254-foot yacht, 54 and a half, or 50, I forget. But it said the dimensions exactly, and I knew that was Daryl's yacht.
That a boy.
And so I saw this silhouette throw a bottle, like, out the water, you know, at the water at me, with, like, a note in it, and it looked like someone, like, you know, motioning to call me. But they didn't put a top on the bottle, so by the time it started coming towards me, it sunk to the bottom of the dang ocean.
Boy, that's unfortunate. You gotta hate that when that happens.
But next time I go back, though, like, we're gonna go out this week, so I'll make sure I have a drink with him for you.
Tell him, Scotty and Elmo say, hey.
Miller Lite.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So how are you holding it down up there?
I was very ill this week. I didn't make it in to the conference Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday.
Iller than normal?
Yeah. I had to take drugs to get rid of this stuff.
Oh man, the kind the captain takes?
No, not those.
Oh boy, yeah, we're getting ready. You know, I'm sure I'll see Daryl today anyway, because we're getting ready to go to this art fair type thing, and it's like anybody who's anybody is there, so I'm sure he'll be there.
Okay, well, you say hello to him. I gotta take one more call, and then I gotta take a break.
Yep.
All right.
Well,
wait, when are you coming back next week? Coming back next week?
Oh yeah, I'll be back next week.
Okay, very good.
All right. Or yeah, Saturday or Sunday or something like that.
Okay, all right. One more
talk
call.
Talk to you later.
All right. One more
Get
call.
Get down the rebound.
Yeah, yep. The rebound. That's us. good morning. You're on Kenosha today.
Good morning. This is Ganga from Libertyville.
Ganga, my man. I'm glad you called.
For what reason?
Well, I have
He's
questions.
He's always glad you called.
I have
called.
Questions.
I find that hard to believe, Mr. Good Looking.
You should see the twinkle in his eye as soon as you start talking. He's
no,
like,
I have some Valentine's questions.
Dreamy and all.
Apparently, Valentine's Day was started as a pagan fertility festival that was dated as far back as the 6th century B.C. And
did you say a pig?
Pagan.
Pagan.
Oh, a pagan. I thought you said pig. A pig festival.
No, well, I'm getting to this.
Close.
Roman priests would sacrifice. This is where you come in. Sacrifice goats and dogs and use their blood-soaked hides to slap women on the streets as a fertility blessing. They would then take their names and put them in an urn and be selected to be paired with a man for a year. Is that one of your customs?
Those were the days, my friend. I thought they'd never end.
You'd sing and dance forever and a day?
Oh, yes. You know the tune, then.
Oh, yeah.
Very good, Mr. Good-Looking.
So, do you buy Valentine's presents for all your nine ex-wives?
Certainly not. Though it's a complete waste of money and time. However, I would like to tell you about my first gift.
Okay, all right. Wayne, get your hand on that button.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you want me to tell you about my kiss when I was bent over, or do you want me when I was upright?
Let's go upright.
Let's go upright.
That sounds safer.
Upright. It was with my great uncle Babu. I was 9 years old. He was a very good kisser in his day.
Oh.
In fact, one of the top 10 kisses I've ever had.
From your uncle?
Yes, Uncle Babu.
Uncle Babu. Did Uncle Babu have a beard?
I certainly did. It tickled.
I was going to say, yeah. At 9 years old, I'd imagine it tickled a bit.
Yes, yes. It was quite an experience. So I know you gentlemen will probably never receive an experience like that until you are 12.
Well, in Wisconsin,
never
we don't.
Experienced one of those
I've never been kissed by my uncle, but I know we got some people down in Arkansas that probably been kissed by their cousin or uncle. So I guess.
Oh, certainly, I probably know a few.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So this is an acceptable custom to be kissed at 9 years old.
Yes.
He didn't slip you any tongue, did he?
Certainly not. That would be rude. I couldn't get past the man hair beard. Especially when I was chewing gum.
Now, just for those snot-nosed little Pakistani kids that are listening, we don't condone this type of behavior where you go kiss
certainly your... not. Not no. now. Back then, it was a custom.
Yeah. Now, Shirley doesn't seem to have much going on for Valentine's Day, and she wants you to be...
Oh, yes, she will have. I've bought her this slinky little number.
Uh-oh.
It's a peekaboo. Yes, it's going to be excellent on her.
Is she?
I will probably not be able to see it, but I will deliver it.
Peekaboo.
I will have it FedEx to her.
Why don't you deliver it in person, being the man that you are?
Well, because I do not want to be shot by her husband.
So you're saying this is pretty suggestive, huh?
Oh, I suggest that she wears it immediately. That would be my suggestion. Oh, yes, she's going to look very fine in it.
Now, although we don't condone the kissing of uncles to relatives, but we do condone the peekaboo stuff. That's right up our alley. We're applauding you.
Yes, would you like to hear about my very best kiss?
Make it snappy.
We're way behind here.
But if you haven't got time, I will not tell you.
No, go ahead. Well, we can wait.
Make it snappy?
Yeah.
Yes, that's what she said.
It's okay.
Yes, it was my stepsister, and she was quite a good kisser in her own right, too. She was 19, and I was 15. It was quite an experience.
Hey, Ganga, one last question. Do you ever kiss anybody outside the family?
Oh, certainly not. That would be unhygienic. I don't know where those mouths and things have been.
Got to keep the bloodlines pure.
Yeah. I got to get to a break, Ganga. Have a happy day.
That was an excellent point. Well done, Mr. Good-Looking. Have a wonderful Valentine's Day, gentlemen.
You too, Ganga. Right.
See you, Ganga.
Bye now.
Thank you.
Oh, man, we're 9 minutes
You're way behind.
I'm
way behind. Well, we got to come back. Who's on the weather?
Pete
today.
All right.
Again, a very good morning to everybody. This is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 9th Valentine's edition of the award-winning Kenosha Today Weekly Report. Look at Wacky Wayne. We have a caller already.
Not anymore.
Oh, shucks.
Caller.
If it's important, they'll call back.
Yeah, okay. I was going to interrupt my train of thought here to take this.
You already did.
Well, call
now
back.
Now back, get back on the rails.
Coming to you live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WLIP, spreading the love. We spread the love every week. Not just on Valentine's. Here on the red hot airways of WLIP to over 1.4 million people residing in the Kenosha Today Nation. Again, we invite you to join the thousands of fans who have already signed up and liked us on Facebook. And, got to get rid of that. First 40 minutes, not one bad text. So I'm on.
Congratulations. What about voicemail?
Oh, no, that was a business related.
Oh, okay.
Here's my caller.
Here's our caller.
Our
I
caller.
Don't know if it's your caller.
Well, we'll see.
Silver.
Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today.
Well, this is cool. I got you guys right away, right out of the box.
Oh, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Were you calling before?
I was, yeah. I think you were in commercial.
Yeah, we had to do that. But anyway, what can we do for you, Paul?
Well, I was really encouraged by your first two callers calling in and talking about their past history and how a lot of that seemed to take place around this area. And it got me to thinking about a gentleman who you know, probably you could say has a Valentine's love affair with Kenosha and the past in Kenosha and the history of Kenosha. And, you know, it speaks in great conviction about that past. Mm-hmm. I understand that individual's writing a book. Did you guys know that?
No.
No.
Yeah, it's called Trolley Cars and Salad Bars, The Rich History of Travel and Dining in Kenosha.
Sounds like a bestseller.
And I guess he's doing a book signing at the Stella. And I would love for him to call in and share a little bit more about that.
Thank you for, again, Paul, for putting more gas on the fire and fanning the flames here.
No problem. Happy Valentine's Day, gentlemen.
Thanks,
love
Paul.
Love the show.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
I guess we'll be hearing from that guy.
Maybe.
Also in the House of Cheer this morning, Little Cupid's right-hand go-to guy, Elmo Schneider, joins our encounter.
You really can't spell.
Well, now
did
what?
You look at that word?
Did I get too many L's? I was nervous this morning.
Didn't we say that was from last week?
That was a typo. That was a typo. I put too many in there.
You just did. It's not that you don't know how to spell. You just can't type.
No, I was nervous this morning.
Why?
I had the shakes this morning. So I guess we'll
three
do the
days
same
not
thing.
Going to the conference. I see the problem.
That's right. Yep. My body was in withdrawals.
Yeah.
So the deal is just like we did the last time. If the person names the secret word and can spell it, I'll bump it up $5.
Sure.
Okay.
And I'll just take
spell
this.
It correctly. No, or we spell won't. It the way you
spell
did.
The way I did.
Okay. Right.
Got to have some challenge in here.
Right.
Sounds like some chaos to me. But
Joining the Kenosha State Love Show, the Love Doctor, gearing up for Valentine's Day. Spider Ronnie slithers on the Kenosha Today Love Trolley this morning.
Yeah.
Of course, engineering board operating the Love Trolley. The original Greek god here at Alpha Media. Wacky Wayne's all jacked up because he's appeared in the finals for the Kenosha News Cutest Couple Award. That's way overrated.
Well, yeah.
But I hope you win. I think you've got a chance.
Why wouldn't I? I don't live in Kenosha. It makes perfect sense.
What do they care?
Yeah.
It says cutest couple. It doesn't say you had to...
You had to reside in the city limits?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool. Then I'm in.
All right.
In there like swimwear.
Swimwear? What are you going down to the Kenosha Snow Days Festival?
Heck,
I brought
that
up before.
In your thong?
This year's theme is beach party.
Rocking the banana hammock. Strutting my stuff for all to see right there by City Hall. I'm sure I won't get in any trouble for that.
Do you spend Tuesday and Thursdays with Gunga on some kind of encounter?
Some sort of exchange program. Yeah.
This year's theme in the Snow Days Festival is the beach party. Somebody's got to help me out. I don't understand why a beach party is the festival theme.
Because you're channeling summer.
Well, it's snow days. You know,
sure.
I don't get it. I just...
Yeah, but in the summer, do you celebrate snow at all? No. So you're trying to celebrate summer, bring it around. Everybody's going to be wearing Hawaiian pullovers. Big puffy coats
I'm
with
old
Hawaiian
school.
Prints.
It's winter. It should be a winter theme.
Or
a Hawaiian shirt over your snowmobile suit.
There you go. Yeah, there you go.
Whatever it takes.
Where am I at here?
Still in Studio A here.
Coming up
WLIP.
After the 11:30 break, our weekly editorial segment, High Five Zingers and Doofuses. This week it's As the
Broken Heart Turns.
Of course, no one in the first half hour has won this morning's secret word. And like I said, if you say the secret word, we're going to give you an extra, and you win the $20. If you can spell it the way I spelt it, you get an extra $5.
And you're very special.
And you're very special. I did that on purpose.
Oh, yeah, of course you did.
Also, this show is being recorded, I guess, right? For you can relive the magic tomorrow.
It is?
You know, I
should have hit the button to record it.
Oh. I got a letter from the NFL commissioner, Roger Goodell, and cease and desist using the word Super Bowl.
Yeah?
I just told him to shove off.
Okay.
I know Trump personally.
I'm sure.
Going to build a wall around every football stadium in the country. Special thanks to Elmo. We can find the Kenosha Today Show 365 days a year. Easy. Don't get me... I just got over the cold.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, after the 11 o'clock break, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category, the top 10 signs nobody wants to be your Valentine. And now, boys and girls... Oh, we're way behind. It's time to play Kenosha's fastest-growing game show sensation. the lightning round of City in Jeopardy, sponsored by the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. And to be eligible, no one from your household could have won any contest on WIP within the last 60 days. We will now clear the phone lines.
Clear.
And I'm going to read the question, which is a very sophisticated, intelligent, multiple-choice question. And you will then get three somewhat intellectual answers to choose from. After that, you will hear the... And the first caller to correctly answer the question wins a Kenosha Today $25 gift certificate to the Boathouse Pub and Eatery, located at 4917 7th Avenue here in Kenosha. Open Monday through Friday at 11 a.m., featuring weekly lunch and dinner specials to include reduced prices during the happy hour Monday through Fridays from 3 to 6 p.m. and enjoy a beautiful waterfront view and stop in for their big Sunday brunch serving from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. And if you're planning a party or a banquet, call Joyce at 262-654-9922 or you can find them on the web at boathousekenosha.com. Here's the very sophisticated question. What is the number one way to tell that potholes here in Kenosha are very big? You know, we had a caller, Father Marcus, called in a couple weeks ago and complimented
Anthony Kennedy about filling them all in. Yeah,
after the
and
snow.
It was the smoothest ride. Now all of a sudden we had a little, some of these potholes are a little on the rough side. But what's the one, number one way to tell that the potholes here in Kenosha are very big? A, they all have city parking meters. B, most have gift shops, salad bars, and free copies of the Kenosha News. Or C, El Chapo has used them as a hideout. First caller, 262-694-1050. What is the number? Oh, we have a caller already.
Boy, they're right on it.
Right on.
Yeah, okay.
Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today. Who's this?
This is Susan.
Susan.
Hey, Susan.
Okay, Susan. Now, here's the deal. Hang on. I got to build.
Alrighty.
I got to build up the act.
You may not want to build up the act. You don't have a lot of time.
Time, right?
I got to build this act. We're going to stay with this. Susan deserves this.
Okay.
Susan deserves what?
Just so you know, Susan, this is a very legitimate contest.
Oh, you asked for it.
Okay.
And today's very sophisticated question.
I hope I get it right.
Has been licked, wait a minute, licked and sealed in an official Kenosha Day envelope and kept in a Long Island iced tea glass on Funk and Wagnalls porch in last night's production meeting. And you, Susan, with all your powers, being the all-omission, all-knowing, all-telling sage soothsayer and former Kenosha trial driver, will ascertain the correct answer to this very sophisticated question. Right, Susan?
That's right.
Okay. Do you remember what the question is?
No.
Okay. All right, here's Susan. What is the number one way to tell that the potholes here in Kenosha are very big? A, they all have city parking meters. B, most have gift shops, salad bars, free copies of the Kenosha News. Or C, El Chapo has used them as a hideout. Susan.
The last one, El Chapo.
El Chapo has used them as a hideout. Yes, that's the correct answer.
Oh, thank you.
So, Susan, do you listen to this dribble?
Yes, I turn it on every Saturday.
Oh, you need more therapy, dear.
I need to get a life.
Find something to do with your Saturday morning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't you have cleaning and toilets to clean? Something better to do than
you can do at the same time.
My question is, not that I'm hitting, I just want to know if for Valentine's coming up. Are you married? Are you married?
No.
Okay.
Divorced.
Okay, well, so you won't be getting your ex a Valentine's unless
it's...
A knife set or something.
Cement shoes.
Cement shoes.
Well, he's already in the cemetery, so.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Hey,
all right.
Susan, where was your first kiss?
My first kiss was at St. James School when I was about third grade.
Third grade? That's about
wow, that's
nine?
A start.
Yeah. It was underneath the, he sat next to me on the desk and he bent down to get the pencil or something and I bent down and we kissed.
Right in class?
That's what I like, a good Catholic girl.
Frank Zappa has a song
about that. So do you remember the guy's name?
I always remember it's Charlie's.
Charlie?
Yep.
So it was just a little peck on the lips? Or?
Yeah, very, very.
Well, 9 years old.
Peck.
St. James, huh? Well, that's pretty good. I wonder how... Charlie, if you're listening... Give us a call, 262-694-1050.
See if he remembers it differently.
Yeah. Yeah. There's always two sides to every story, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
So 9 years old, that was kind of young, don't you think? Were your hormones flowing at that time?
I didn't even think much of it.
Well, that's not saying much about Charlie, you know. Imagine what he's probably sitting at home in some bar having a shot and a beer going, my first kiss was Susan, what's her name, at St.
James.
And it wasn't much at all.
Yeah, I don't know.
You don't know.
Okay.
All right, I don't know what to say.
Okay. All right, now, Susan, Monday I'm going to send you out a $20 gift certificate.
Well, thank you very much.
And off the air, Wacky Wayne's going to get all your address and your phone number, and I'll send this out. And feel free to join us at the boathouse. And if you're bring your certificate, and you might want to bring some extra cash too.
It's a very good place to be.
Yep. Well, very good. Well, thanks for playing, and enjoy your day.
Okay, have a good day too. Okay.
Here, we got to get to
some sponsors here. See.
Just threw that out there.
Oh yeah, might as well throw it out there. Yeah.
A couple of the other items we're talking about, other than Valentine's, we would like to have you call back. We'd like to know where you had your first kiss. 9 years, bud. That's. I think I was. I was back on from my honeymoon. I was 25 at the time. I had
the first kiss. Yeah. Back from your honeymoon, you didn't get a kiss on the honeymoon.
I was a slow learner.
All right. Kiss on the altar.
Right. No. No kissing the bride.
This was a goofy church, you know.
Okay. What, did you have to slap her with a goat hide first?
You know, talking about at the altar, I was talking to my one daughter about her sister's wedding. It was at the Kemper Center. It was in September, and it was really hot. So the place is packed, and I'm walking my daughter down.
Sure.
Now, my soon-to-be son-in-law,
yeah.
I give him her hand.
Right.
I whispered in his ear, I says, "This is not a loan." And he says, "What do you mean?" I goes, "I don't want her back." She's yours.
Quick, right.
Speed up the ceremony. Right. Give her a kiss and let's go to the party. You know.
Right.
One of the other things, officials are seeking input on the Uptown Street project, and I'm thinking of going over there. And the thing that piques my interest over the Uptown project,
sure,
is I want to know where they're going to put the kiosks to put all the bulletproof vests in. You know, they have this kiosk down in the harbor to save lives.
Right, yeah.
Well, you got to have probably at least 6 kiosks in 22nd Avenue from, let's say, 50th Street down to, maybe 63rd. And you're going to have to put a kiosk in every body with a bulletproof vest.
Uptown. Well, that's technically 60th to Roosevelt Road. It's just a three-block span in there.
That makes perfect sense to me.
Okay.
I mean, if you can put kiosks with throw rings down in the harbor to save lives.
To potentially save lives, yes.
This could potentially save lives on 22nd Avenue.
Unless they get shot in the face.
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, this is a little trouble. they had the polar bear plunge out at the Brat Stop.
They did.
And here's a picture
of
the 95 Will Rock team.
Yeah.
Jumping in this freezing cold water.
It's true, they did.
My point is, and they call Elmo and I crazy.
they were raising money for Special Olympics.
Yeah. I know, but geez, why don't you just send them a check? Look at this. These guys.
They're all wearing onesies. It's okay.
These FM people are a little on the, they're on the other side.
Well, yeah.
My God.
The other side of the hall, yeah.
And, you know, they're jumping in with sweat clothes on. I mean, of course, I can see why some of these, I better not go there.
You're trying to find the words?
Yeah, I know what the words are, but I better not go there.
It's probably better if you
anyway,
don't.
All those people.
They still get the good studio, though. That's...
Yeah, they got the last laugh. They're sitting over there in the lap of luxury, and we're sitting over here with hope and prayer and a couple tapes, rolls of duct tape. So, and then one more item before we go to break. Picture in the Kenosha News this morning. Apparently there was a golf course down, Elmo, in the Allendale area in the late 1800s.
Yeah, that's the original Kenosha Country Club was there.
Oh, really?
Allendale was built on what used to be the country club.
Okay, well, I got a picture of this guy. And he's teeing off in his late 1800s, and look who his caddy is. He's got a woman with a hat and the dress holding his clubs.
Mm-hmm. As well, he should have a woman holding his club.
Yep.
This set.
Happy Valentine's Day.
This set a bad precedent for golfers.
I don't think
in centuries to come.
Nick Faldo used to have his wife caddy for him.
Really?
Yeah.
You've never had a woman hold your club for you?
I did one time, and then we'll go a break.
Just this one time?
I took a gal golfing. This is years ago.
Sure.
We get to the boathouse, go figure, and somebody says, "Did you take any mulligans?" And she says, "No, we didn't start drinking until we got here." we're going to the break?
In a couple of seconds.
Oh, okay. I got some good stuff when we get back.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. If you just joined us, this is Uncle Scotty Barter, and welcome to the February 9th Valentine's Pick to Click edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report. We are live and local, which is always a challenge for, at least for most of us boys and girls. If you just joined us here in our Kenosha Today Encounter Group, we are broadcasting live from Studio A here at AM 1050 WLIP on your radio dial, 262-694-1050. We are brought to you this morning by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. As you can tell, if you follow this dribble for any length of time, we take serious journalism to an all-time high. We span the globe, reporting on national and state stories, local issues, basically trying to be your go-to guys for all the fake news stories that are being reported these days. Joining us this morning, the real Cupid of Valentine's Day, Elmo Schneider, is here waiting to shoot his love arrow to...
I'm not wearing the diaper this morning, though. That's the...
Well, then I am.
At least somebody is.
For a different reason. You gonna? You remember your first kiss?
Not really.
Were you high or what?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Nope. He's had so many.
And of course, every young snot-nosed little kid's role model, our sweetheart video coordinator, Spider Ronnie, is here. Spider, you remember your first kiss?
When I met you, sweetheart.
It's when I met. That's why you're right, Wayne. Don't give him a microphone.
I told you.
Performing as both our engineer and board operator, a role model in his own right, the Kenosha Today Kissing Bandit, Wacky Wayne, embraces us with his presence this morning. You, what is he doing over
He's
there?
He's making smooch noises over there.
Is, remember your first kiss?
Yeah.
What was her name? Or his name, yeah. Whichever.
Yeah. This day and age, let's not,
Well, I mean, if Gunga's uncle is kissing him, you know, you guys in Illinois do things a little goofy.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, that's, that was Gunga's uncle, Babu.
Babu.
His whiskers did tickle. The beard tickled. Quite fantastic. Yes. He was a good kisser, just like Gunga said.
You know, I had a guy when I was in grade school.
Good for you.
No.
That's a bold move. Yeah. Way to come out, Scotty. Here you've been complaining about all these ladies, and now we know why. All right.
I was trying to say I had this friend. You know how he would practice kissing?
In
the third grade, he would put two hot dogs together. Raw hot dogs.
I see why you guys were good friends.
I don't know why I brought that up. I just thought I'd...
Yeah, why?
Anyway.
That explains a lot why you're so keen on Anthony Kennedy in a leotard skating on the ice rink.
Well, I think he's an attractive guy.
I know you do. Your brother from another mother.
Status of this morning's Secret Word Challenge, sponsored by Barter's Financial Planning Services. And again, if you happen to get the word, it's $20 gift card I send you. And if you happen to spell it the way I purposely spelled it.
Right, purposely.
Just to throw everybody off.
Right.
I'll bump it up $5. Normally coming up this half hour, Captain Mike will call us with his message of hope and desperation.
He's wearing the diaper.
Yeah, I wonder how he's doing. It was like 80 degrees down in Mexico.
He's probably melting.
You got a sweaty diaper.
All right, I guess we're going to do the top 10, huh?
Yeah, might as well. It's time for
written
such
in
things.
Our home office at Amen Corner on the deck at the Boathouse Pub and Eatery. Where gray hairs matter, this week's top 10 thought-provoking category. These are the top 10 signs nobody wants to be your Valentine. I'll slow it down.
All right.
Number 10. Your favorite pickup line is, are those bruises on your forehead where the 10-foot pole kept hitting you? Number 9. Says he'll pick you up just as soon as the police standoff is over. Number 8. You're listed on social media as friend of Putin. Number 7. The babes just don't seem to dig your new Foxconn uniform. Number 6. Your 50-gallon stash of Kentucky jelly is beyond the expiration date. Number 5. You have the ability to break wind 8 times an hour. Number 4. You've called into the Kenosha Today Show more than 6 times in the last month. Number 3. The humming noise is your leg monitor continually going off. Number 2. Your profile name on a dating site is Silver Fox. And the number 1 sign no one wants to be your Valentine. You've had to ask Uncle Scotty for tips on celibacy. That's the comedy part. That's the comedy part. See? See?
See? See?
Look at that. A lot better.
Yes.
Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today.
Good morning, old gangster of love.
Gangster. Is this the space cowboy?
Yes, I'd like to thank Shirley for those kind words earlier in the show.
She didn't mean it. She was bluffing. She was bluffing.
Hey, Dennis. Well, it was mostly for Nancy, I'm sure. Yep. I just got thrown in there.
That was very nice.
Hey, get this. I get this text from my texting coordinator, Mark, not his real name. And he's got a picture of a gal sitting, you know, behind the steering wheel. And she's very scantily clad.
She's very healthy.
And it says, you should always be wearing a seatbelt. And safety first for Valentine's Day. I didn't know they made...
Reverse airbags.
That's about... Somebody, if this gal gets in an accident, somebody's going to get hurt.
Oh, God.
So, Dennis, the theme today is Valentine's Day. Where was your first kiss?
Oh, wow.
And don't say on the lips, because that's been used already.
I think it was when my mom sent me off to kindergarten. That's the first one I remember.
Kindergarten? That's like five.
Your mom doesn't count.
Yeah, you're... Oh, yeah. Gunga calls in and he says his uncle Babbo was at age nine. But, no, I'm talking about...
I know. I got to say maybe my junior year in high school.
So you're, what, about 15 or 16?
Yeah. Yeah, somewhere around there.
What were you saving yourself for? You just a little shy?
I was shy as a youngster. I really was.
16, you remember her name?
Andrea, I think it was.
Andrea. And do you remember where?
On the lips.
Oh, come on.
Oh, sure. You remember the first girl you kissed's name, but your wife, what's her name, is another story.
we're more mature than that, Dennis. Where was this?
I was taking her to homecoming at my high school. I think it could have been somewhere around the high school.
Was this a kind of a good night kiss, or just you trying to get lucky or get excited, or what?
This was a probing kiss, you might say.
Ooh.
A probing kiss. Now, you're going to have to describe that for me, because it's been a little while for Uncle Scotty. And
well, that's the kind of kiss I think you give when you're checking out the response you'll get.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? You got to figure, if you went to homecoming, you already got some flowers, and you got something invested in this, right?
Yeah.
And you got the tickets to the dance, so you probably got at least $30-some invested in this, right?
You know, I really got jammed up on that day because I didn't drive. My dad wouldn't let me drive. I lived in Chicago. He said, you're not driving until you graduate from high school. So my buddy had a car. So he was driving until I found out a couple days before homecoming. He did something terrible. Whatever he did, he got grounded. So I'm scurrying around last minute, and I had a triple instead of double with this other couple, another buddy of mine, which meant he had a Buick Skylark, which meant it wasn't that big. One of us had to sit in the front seat, and one of us had to sit in the back seat.
That's not good.
You should have put the guy in the trunk. Hey, you know, did you ever go on a double date and think, geez, I wish I was with my partner's
girlfriend? Yeah, with the other girl.
Well, you know, I think Rick Springfield wrote a song about that, I think.
Oh, okay. So,
just to play that in a band.
So Andrea, 16, you're, you know, Sue from Ingleside, she was nine, and she was from the Chicago area, and she remembers... she was 11.
She was 11.
11, and she was she remembers the guy's name, Bobby Mingberg and Billy the Dugan. And they were playing Spin the Bottle. Did you ever play Spin the Bottle in those crazy...
I played Empty the Bottle, but never Spill the Bottle.
Well, you're a double threat, aren't you? Dennis, you're a real catch.
I'm telling you, Vince McMahon gave a Valentine gift to all the... football widows of the world.
Vince McMahon?
Yeah, he started the new football league kicks off tonight.
That's right.
Have to be sure I watch that. Where's the first time you place you kissed your what's her name? I can tell you the first time I kissed her, but I'll let you go first since you're married. Since you're married to her.
I think it was in front of either the vodka or the potato chip factory. I can't remember which one it was, but no, I think it was at Italian Fest in Racine.
And what moved you? Were you alcohol playing any part in this?
We might have had one drink at the time, but
oh, sure. Well,
we still go to that festival to this day. It's a really good festival.
You just don't kiss anymore now that you're married.
It's kind of the way it goes.
Yes, we do. Shirley's so right that we are a cute couple, you know?
Oh, God. Well, I guess. What are you going to get her for Valentine's Day?
Probably something to do with the Minions. She's a Minion nut. She loves the Minions.
From the movie?
So if I can find some kind of Minion-related item, something like that.
A lot of thought has gone into this, I can tell.
Well, she doesn't need any more bottles. She's got enough. She could probably open her own Jared's or whatever you want to call it.
This other gal that won the prize, she was married 47 years. Is she the one? That won? She was married 47. What are you going to get your husband? Says, I won't nag him for 24 hours. Now, that says I love you, don't you think?
I really do. And for me to be married 47 years, I'd have to live to 100.
Yeah, but we're talking collectively. You know,
I heard about the other lady talking lovingly about her deceased husband, too.
Yeah, well, hey, speaking of that, I just happen to have, you must have read my notes here. This gal lived in Ontario, and she died. It says, it hurts me to admit it. This was in her obit. It hurts me to admit it, but I, Mrs. Ron Hicks from Baysville, have passed away. I passed away peacefully with my eldest daughter, Brenda, at my side on February 2nd, 2018. I leave behind my loving husband, Ron Hicks, whom I often affectionately refer to as a horse's ass. So, I also left behind my children, whom I tolerated over the years. She names them all. And so then she says, one of her last thing was, I finally have a smoking hot body. You know why? She got cremated.
Well, she had the sense of humor even to the end. That's great.
Yeah, but to refer to your husband affectionately as a horse's ass. Boy, and she puts it in her old bed. I mean, that shows some spunk, right?
Well, you know, maybe on occasion they had arguments, and her husband said, like the old line on Seinfeld, you want a piece of me? You want a piece of me? So, you know, that's why she might have called him. Who knows?
You know, I was doing some research on Valentine's Day, and you know what the biggest cause of arguments for married couple?
Financial, right?
Money. Nope, going to the mall. Have I hit a nerve? Going to the mall.
Oh, wow.
I don't know
I tell you, if she's at her mall, wherever I'm at, I'm out there exploring. I'm out there doing my own thing. Right. I don't, you know.
You're sitting in the car, behaving like a good little boy, little puppy dog, eating chips and having a soda. you know where Valentine started. I said this in the last hour. It was in the 6th century B.C., and Roman priests would sacrifice goats and dogs and use their blood-soaked hides to slap women on the streets as a fertility blessing. That shows creativity, don't you think?
And sensitivity.
And then they put their names in a urn, not a urinal, but an urn, and be selected to be paired with a man for only a year. So after the year's up, you can walk. No, none of this community property or, you know, I don't like you.
A temporary marriage card, yeah. Okay.
That sounds like good.
It has to be renewed every year, I guess.
No, this you just walk, and you can take your blood-soaked hides and slap another woman down the street. Anyway, Dennis, you say hi to the missus.
I just want to also wish Happy Valentine's Day, if I could, to all the forlorn out there who really don't have anybody and are standing all alone at the gas station alone.
Oh, he's talking about us.
No, not you.
You,
guys.
Baby.
You guys dabble in the science.
Elmo's progressing ahead, and I'm kind of lost in the I'm in the dabble, and I'm in the gutter, and whatever you call it. You know,
then you're standing all alone at the gas station 11. You have to use the self-service.
That's very good, Dennis. I've been kicked to the curb so many times that I got this toe tag on my garbage guy. Looks for me every Monday morning. All right. We're way behind. All right, Dennis. Well,
what else is new?
And because it's Valentine's week, tell the missus I won't be out there this week.
All right.
It's kind of compassionate.
See you, Dennis.
Bye.
All right. Anybody want to call in? We're still looking for more Valentine's. I don't want to talk about Trump, although Trump attacks ridiculous partisan probes. You know, I thought his speech was pretty good.
Oh, the State of the Union?
Mm-hmm. And he says...
Yeah, whoever wrote it was brilliant.
Yeah, he stayed right on it. And then he says, well, we should be... do all this stuff, nonpartisan, et cetera, et cetera. And then the very next day, he's calling Chuck Schumer a nasty son of a bitch. and the guy from Virginia, he choked like a dog, and then he calls Joe Biden dumb. And he was a terrible student. He dismissed Howard Schultz. He doesn't have a shot, and then he went off on Elizabeth Warren with the nickname of Pocahontas. So that's the way to cement good relationships.
Sure.
I mean, what better way to do that? Anybody want to play Stump the Chumps? 262-694-1050. If you want to, you know what that means. It's time for all our listeners to strut their stuff and try to stump the chumps. And if you're successful, you then get the privilege and the high honor of joining us as a guest host here in an upcoming show. Boy, man, it doesn't get much better. We give out a lot of money prizes, but coming in here to be with Elmo and I and the rest of all my children. And they can see for themselves what it takes to bring intelligence, sophistication to and be barely smarter than a fifth grader. 262-694-1050. Now you got to know it's either music or a trivia question.
Right. And you must know the answer.
We have a caller, right?
No.
Okay. Somebody tried to fool Uncle Scotty.
Something like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my first kiss wasn't. I was back from my honeymoon by a couple weeks before I got kissed.
Okay. That's rough.
I was in this Planned Parenthood deal, you know. That's what that was the old people that in the Catholic religion, and they said the people that practice the rhythm method, you know what they call those people?
Huh.
Parents.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was drummers.
Them too.
262-694. Do we have nothing? Either one of them, huh? Okay, well, we'll put Stump the Chumps off to the side here. And
moving
we can,
right along.
Recognize KRS Painting Corporation, specializing in commercial.
Hello.
Hello.
Who's this?
Hey. Terry. Who's this?
Uncle Scotty.
Hey, I got a stumpy question for you.
Okay. This is Jerry with a G.
No, Terry. With a T.
Oh, Terry.
With a T.
Oh, I think
Terry
I had this
with
problem.
A T.
Okay, okay. I'm not a very good speller.
Right.
That's all right.
Okay, Terry, what is it?
What disease can you catch from touching armadillo skins and shells?
Wait a minute. Disease can you catch?
I know that.
By touching, hang on,
armadillo?
Armadillo skins. Okay, Elmo seems to have this already. Elmo.
Leprosy.
You got it.
Oh, Terry, don't you just feel a little, what's the word I'm looking for?
Crushed.
Stupid is what I was saying. No, I was just kidding.
Why would you know that?
Yeah, that's a very good question, Elmo. How would
I'm
you
just
know
a
that?
Fountain of useless information here. That's it.
It's really because he touched an armadillo and parts of him have fallen
got
off.
Leprosy
he
and
got
had to take
cured,
the meds.
But...
Yeah.
Oh, geez.
Oh,
So, Terry, where was your first kiss?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear it.
How old were you and where were you for your when you got first kiss? We're talking about Valentine's now, you know.
My first kiss,
yeah.
Fifth grade? Fifth grade with Chucky Waller.
You remember his name?
Oh, yeah, he was the neighbor kid. He was 22. No, sorry, he was only in fifth grade, too, but I just had to throw that
so
in.
So fifth grade would be about 10 years old, right?
Yeah.
So
great.
Where did this romantic tete-a-tete take place?
By my doghouse in the back in the swamp.
Boy, nothing says, give me a kiss, Chucky. Plant one on me.
Like
let's,
a swamp.
Let's go back to the right. swamp and lay it on me.
We live down at the lakefront in Winthrop Harbor, and our street backed the swamp. And our dog house, the dog lives back behind the garage in the swamp. So there you go.
So, oh, we have just a second. Did they play this song? Just what? A second.
Okay.
Just a second. I'm keeling something.
Who let the dogs out?
Is that how? Did you kiss him, Terry? Or did he kiss you?
Wow, I don't know. I think we both agreed on it that we would try it and practice it.
Oh, boy.
It was like, what do you think, you know?
So
we worked at it.
did you make this guy marry you?
No.
So no. Did you?
Fifth grade.
So did you kiss
We're
him?
We're not getting married.
You what?
You're not
kidding. We weren't getting married. We just wanted to practice kissing.
Well, that's good. Who better to practice mm-hmm. with than your neighbor kid?
Perfect.
So, how many times did you practice? Like a couple hours
I
a day?
I can't recall, but it was... No. It was just that one day. For a couple hours, you know.
A couple hours? 10-year-olds pacing themselves in the swamp.
Yeah, you don't have a long attention span, you know. It's like, okay, let's go chase the dog or do something.
Let's do something else, yeah.
So when you come back and your hair's all messed up, how would you tell your mom?
I always came back that way. I lived in the swamp.
Say, Terry, are you available for parties?
Yeah, I'm glad you asked just for my first kiss. You didn't ask further, so we don't have to go there, you know.
Well, you brought it up. I didn't.
Yeah.
Well, so this practice when you're... in fifth grade, at the age of 10, has this helped you develop into a well-rounded individual taking your place in society?
Yes.
How so?
I became a cop.
Oh, jeez. I take back everything. You're a cop? You're a cop, really?
Oh, no, I'm retired now.
Oh. Okay. I was going to say, you don't carry a gun anymore, do you?
I'm retired now.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. You still have a weapon, don't you?
Well, of course. Cops don't get rid of their guns.
No.
So, where were you an officer?
I was in the Waukegan Police Department and the Lake County Sheriff's Department.
Hmm. Oh, really?
Very good.
Did you ever have a guy, when you pulled him over, maybe he was a little bit overserved, try to kiss you?
I know.
No.
I detect something from that.
No, they weren't in the kissing mood when they were talking to me.
No. Yep. Well, Terry, you know, I'm glad that you shared and bared your soul with this kissing thing.
Yeah, I can't. You just totally caught me off guard. I can't believe you knew the answer. I'm so bummed.
Well, this is why they call Stump the Chumps.
I'll try it next week.
We are just not a bunch of dummies here.
Yeah.
No, here's the question. What disease can you get by touching or handling Uncle Scotty?
Well, look at that, Terry. Our time is just about up.
Have a good day, you guys. We'll talk to you next time.
We got to go to a break, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, dear.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
I think we should have asked if she was a police officer before we got into that line of questioning.
Right.
All right.
I think the better question would have been, what disease can't you get from touching Uncle Scotty? It's a smaller list.
That was not called for.
Probably not.
Now we're going to take one more break, and let me go through the boathouse when we know all we got left is...
I thought you were doing that after the show.
Oh, I'm going to be there, but I got to promote them. We are back and heading down the home stretch on Kenosha Today trolley ride this morning. Excuse me, if you just joined us, this is the February 9th Valentine's edition of the Kenosha Today Weekly Report. The good news is we are still broadcasting live to over 1.4 million people residing here in the Kenosha Today Nation. Excuse me, I'm just getting over my cough, as you see.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not spreading diseases.
Uh-huh, sure. That's what you say.
Got a call?
Sure.
Okay.
Nope, guess not.
What happened?
They guess they hung up.
And the bad news is...
They hung up.
The bad news, they found out we're going to be here for the rest of the year.
Well, there's that.
And I promise to be on my best behavior.
I'm sure.
However, I can be provoked.
Doesn't take much.
On occasion. Is he yawning?
Yeah, he's just waking up. He's been asleep for the first half hour. All I needed was a blanket.
being brought to you by our major sponsors, the Boathouse Pub and Eatery and Barter's Financial Planning Services, along with a host of many other very fine local businesses. This morning's cast of characters, the ever-loving Elmo Schneider.
Good morning.
And from the galaxy called Spider-Dome, the Love Doctor, Spider Ronnie the Camera Dude.
Good morning, everybody.
Is he wearing pajamas?
Yes. The little footy pajamas with the little stocking cap, yeah.
Yep.
From Spider-Dome?
Uh-huh.
Along with our engineer board operator, the only man on the planet who has the power to press that one special button that would take this show completely off the air. Hey, you know, somebody asked me, what's the going rate if somebody wanted to bribe you?
What, to hit that button?
Yeah. Is it 20, 50, 100?
Just go for free.
$8, $9, you know.
We are here each and every Saturday morning from 10 a.m. till noon. Also, if you happen to miss our Saturday show, you can tune in tomorrow and noon and relive all the magic of this morning's broadcast. Yeah. And don't forget to join the Kenosha Today Nation. Like us on Facebook. Status of the Secret Word Challenge to win a $20 Boathouse gift card from Barter's Financial Planning Services still yet to be named. Now, what, you want to give a hint?
Sure. Something that flies high in the air.
Psych Astobly.
It's a hint.
Hey, you know, we, Psych Astobly is now, I don't know if we made this kind of an informal announcement. Kenosha Today is going to run Psych Astobly for State Assembly.
State Assembly. That's right.
Well, you know, yeah. His alderman just resigned. John Fox resigned. So
yeah.
We're going to have an open seat. He could run for alderman.
Yeah.
And it's true.
We were talking to Sy yesterday, and we were unsure because initially it was going to be for the assembly. And I said, Sy, which way do you lean? You know,
whichever way.
What I meant was Democrat or Republican.
Right.
And I said, which way do you lean? And he goes, depends on how much I've had to drink.
Right.
So he's our kind of guy.
Well, he's not drinking, though.
No, I know. Well,
he had some health issues.
He's, now that John Fox resigned. Was in the paper this morning, and Sy lives kind of like right down the block from him, so he'd be a great alderman.
Can see each other's house from
that's right,
just like Sarah Palin.
And now, boys and girls, it's time for this week's special editorial segment, High Five Zingers and Doofuses. This morning headliner as the
Broken Heart Turns.
This week's High Five goes to nearly 400 students from Kenosha, Racine, and Walworth counties for declaring their intent to attend Gateway Technical Institute this fall. Being an alum of Gateway, then known as Kenosha Technical Institute, many young people have come to the realization that a four-year college isn't really for them. Yet on the other hand, Gateway provides an excellent opportunity to further your education and put yourselves in a position to land a very good paying job. So to all those who have made this declaration, I applaud and salute you and wish you much success as you strive to be the very best you can be. Elmo, you got a zinger?
Sure. This week's zinger goes to the governor, lieutenant governor, and attorney general of the state of Virginia. They're all in trouble out there. I don't know what the heck's going to happen with it, but it's going to provide some really good entertainment for the next few weeks. That's all I got, Scott.
I got a doofus, but I'll wait till after we got some calls. I'd rather take those first.
Well, sure.
Good morning. You're on Kenosha Today.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Who's this?
This is Bob from Kenosha.
Oh, old crow.
The old crow.
Yeah. secret word. I got it.
Yeah.
It's Scott's ego.
That's two words.
Something that, you know, flies high in the sky, right?
I don't have a ego problem, do you think? I have an identity problem, and I got a couple of flaws here and there, but and I got some issues, but other than that.
Oh, what are flaws? I don't have such a thing. Anyway, I just wanted to let you know what Captain Mike's real intentions are. He's, down south. He's going to come back, sneak across the border as an illegal alien, and then be able to collect Social Security again. That way he gets double Social Security.
He's going to claim asylum.
That's a brilliant plan. Brilliant.
Yeah,
plan.
So he's smart, yeah.
Oh, well, let's not go nuts.
Of course, I think he's escaped from an asylum.
Hey, Mr. Bob, the old crow, we're talking Valentine's Day here. How old were you when you had your first kiss?
Oh, I think I was 14.
14? Was this back on when you came over on the Mayflower?
No, it was when I was visiting with Abraham Lincoln.
Oh, okay. that crowd, huh?
Yep.
Yeah.
Do you remember the gal's name?
I don't remember his name.
His name? His name.
And, and of course, he had to kiss me on the lower cheek. He gave me some crap, and I had to get back to him, and he had to kiss me on my lower posterior. So,
I guess that was more information than I cared to.
Yeah, right.
You opened yourself up for that one, Scotty.
No, it was a sweet young girl. I can't even remember her first name, but it was in the alley behind the movie theater. We came out of the movie theater. And then she told her older brothers about it, and they had quite a serious chat with me.
What, did you have to kiss them too?
No, but I didn't take her out anymore.
Really?
Yeah.
Boy, that's kind of unfair. Well, you hate a gal that kisses and tells. You should have learned your lesson right there. Especially when you tell your older brothers. You should have blamed it all on her. Sure. You know, she kissed you.
Yeah, you know, they'd believe.
Yeah. This at 14, you were just probably getting to the stage of life when your glands were starting to develop, huh?
Yeah, I was a sophomore in high school.
Sophomore in high school.
So,
well,
yeah.
Good for you.
Okay.
What did we learn from this, boys and girls?
Pardon me?
What did we learn from this episode?
Nothing.
Well, good.
Nothing.
life's lessons. All right, Bob. Thanks for calling.
Okay. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We had another caller. They can call us back, 262-694-1050. Oh, I did that one. Elmo gave us this one. My doofus.
Oh, now we're ready for that?
Yeah. Goes to a former Kenosha alderman, and I'm not going to even say his name, for sticking his nose into the business matters of Alderman Holly Kangas, claiming that she was given special treatment when her company inadvertently failed to obtain the necessary permits while rehabbing a couple of homes. To this we say, poppycock. People make mistakes, and sometimes things might have accidentally been overlooked. Mistakes happen all the time in every business. That's why we have erasers on our pencils. We applaud Holly for self-reporting the incidents, and she went and paid off the fines. And I also commend my good friend, Alderman Little Anthony Kennedy, for his positive post on Facebook admonishing this former alderman, who, by the way, was also cited in 2015 for not pulling permits for his own home remodeling. In our view, instead of being a self-proclaimed community watchdog, you're really more like a community hot dog. Waiter, more ketchup and mustard, please.
Who let the dogs out?
And there you have it, folks. As the broken heart turns for this Saturday, February 9th, I'm Scotty Burton. And I
should be expecting some litigation later?
Probably.
All right.
Actually, I could have said the guy's name because he's a bona fide candidate. I'm just not going to stoop down that low and give him recognition he doesn't deserve.
Again? Or
some
more?
I'm not going to.
Okay.
I mean, we'll talk about elections when we talk about elections.
I'm fine with that.
Okay. We got a call?
No, they're unavailable.
I don't know if anybody cares about the Super Bowl ratings. I don't really care anymore. Let's go over. The Super Bowl ratings were down the lowest that they ever had.
Oh, they revised them back up this morning.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, they added 14 million more people to it.
Yeah. It was a pretty good game, but
I don't know where they found them, but
it was a good defensive game.
Good morning, you're on Kenosha Today.
I miss you guys.
Oh.
And the check's in the mail.
How much is it?
Whatever your invoice was. You were worth every penny of it.
What's her name?
Oh, this is what's her name. I have another friend that sounded like you. You were disguising your voice.
Scott doesn't know who you are right now.
I do now.
No, he doesn't. He thinks he knows, but he doesn't know who you are.
You're married to what's his name, right?
And Ron knows who I am, right?
Yeah, Ron. No, wait a minute. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe see?
What is your first name? You got me confused.
Oh, you guys don't got caller ID?
No, I have caller ID.
Right.
They do not have caller ID.
All right, who is this?
So he's thinking you're somebody else, and I'm just sitting over here laughing to myself.
All right, who is this?
I got him going, questions. Huh?
Yeah, you got me going. Oh, who is this?
And now he's getting angry about it, looking to get all emotional. He's getting red in the face. He's going to come over here and look at it himself.
You forget. How could you forget me?
I'm an old guy. I forget very easy.
I guess so.
Okay, who's your...
Who's my daddy?
I wasn't going in that direction, but... how old were you when you had your first kiss?
Oh, maybe... I know where it was, but...
Where?
And I didn't practice for hours like the previous woman.
So you're a natural, right?
But it was playing spin the bottle that it had.
Oh, you're one of those,
okay.
Huh?
Yeah.
So how old were you?
Oh, maybe sixth grade.
Sixth grade, huh? You remember the guy's name?
Yes, I had a long-time crush on him.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, you got lucky then.
What's his first name?
Christopher.
Christopher, oh. What's long time? Did this go to
you? Oh, it's in the summertime. We went to a cottage, and you know how those days go.
Oh. Now, in sixth grade, you're about to be about 12, right?
Right.
So that's about the time a young girl's hormones start to
ratchet up. No, I was an L7, so my hormones weren't.
What's an L7?
Draw it.
Oh. I'm a little slow sometimes, okay?
I know.
L7.
I really do know that after this call.
So
do you know yet?
No. You going to tell me your first name or no? Are you just going to leave me hanging?
I'm going to leave you hanging.
Have you left me hanging before?
But I did write a note on the check in the mail, okay? So maybe you'll get that.
Okay. Is this... Do I know you? Oh, now I know who this is. Now I know this. You have would you confirm or deny that you've flashed in the boathouse?
I will not confirm or nor deny. Yeah.
Now I know who really this is.
All right, now I gotta go. Okay?
Yeah, sure.
Love you guys.
Leave
Bye.
Me hanging.
Bye.
Yeah. It's Yep. What's her name?
What's her name?
Yeah.
There's a lot of what's her names in your life, yeah. Scotty.
Yep.
Good morning, you're on Kenosha today.
Good morning. Is this Scott?
Uh-oh. I'd rather not say.
or shall I say the gangster of love?
Yes.
Well, the gangster of love has kind of been put out to stud.
Well, I just had a call because I heard that was your new handle, and I thought, whoa. With Valentine's Day coming and everything, it's quite an expectation to live up to. But then again, that's my cousin Dennis for you.
Yep. You remember the St. Valentine's Day
Kathy.
Massacre?
This is Dennis's cousin, Kathy.
Hi, Kathy.
Oh, okay. All right.
From Racine. I think we've met, Scott.
Oh, you were down at Elmo's birthday party.
Well, actually, I was. We first met at Holy Rosary Festival.
Which year was that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, maybe it was 2 years ago.
2 years ago.
Okay.
That's way too long. That's way too long. We were having a, you know, beverage of our choice, you remember, you know?
Well,
I think you were having a Diet 7-Up.
That's me.
Now I remember. Yeah, that was you. I was having a Dr. Pepper, and, of course, Dennis was with us, of course.
That's right. I remember now. All right.
Yeah.
So now, Kathy, how old were you when you had your first kiss?
You know, that's what got me to call. I was thinking and thinking. And then I heard that nice lady about her experience, St. James?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In the classroom. And I went to St. Mary's on 39th Avenue, and I can't remember, and I feel terrible. Because I remember everybody's name from school, and I don't know if that's a good sign or not, but I can't remember my first kiss.
But it was at St. Mary's, another good Catholic girl like you, right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And since I, you know, stayed there 8 years, it just had to have happened.
Hey, Kathy, St. Mary's was only a sixth grade school. You stayed there 8 years? Good for you, baby.
I should not have been there that long, should I? Well, they said extra credit.
Yeah, oh. So did you kiss, what grade were you in, do you remember?
Oh, I think, if anything, it would have been fifth.
Fifth, right?
That was the fifth grade.
But
yeah,
you don't remember this guy's name, huh?
Well, I don't think we kissed. I think, you know, that's
well, then
the
what
bad
was it?
Part.
Just blown in the
Pardon?
Wind?
Well, you know, at that age, you think it's a kiss,
you know, you just, you don't want to admit it or what. No, I don't. Maybe I just dreamt I kissed him.
You know, this...
It's kind of sad, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, really.
Yeah.
I'm going to get some help.
You
need to join an encounter group, I tell you.
Yes, yes.
And this guy...
I think it'll be okay.
If this guy's remembering this, he's probably recalling how you grabbed him, and he's going about and bragging. You know, guys like to brag about their conquests.
Well, from what I understand, yeah.
Yeah, well, so...
And we probably ended up in the principal's office, right?
For kissing?
Well, this is... You know, we're going back a few years.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, in the 60s.
Well, are you proud of this now?
I don't know how to cope with it, to tell you the truth. But like I said, there's help around, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Don't worry. Come down to the boathouse
I can call people. Yeah. Maybe I'll just talk to my cousin Dennis about it.
There's a good reliable source.
Yeah.
Go talk to him. He'll take you to the mall in Johnstown.
Maybe talk to his wife, Nancy.
I highly recommend when cases like this, you talk to a male. Don't talk to your sister. She's going to side with you every time. Talk to somebody that's going to give you an objective point of view.
That's true.
Like me.
That is very true.
All right,
Daddy. But listen, with this Valentine's Day coming up, you know, I'm going to really think of you as the gangster of love now. I just can't get it out of my head.
I thought you were married.
Pardon?
I thought you were married.
I am.
Well, don't mention my name.
But I said, when I first met you, you know, it's like, well, there's Scott, you know, and everything's cool, and now you're the gangster of love. I mean, it's quite a handle, you know? Quite a reputation to live up to, especially at Valentine's Day. But I'm sure you'll make it work, right?
Yeah, I'll rise to the occasion. All right. All right, baby.
All right. Thanks nice chatting.
Oh, thanks, sure. Kathy. Anytime.
Oh, okay. Have a good weekend.
Emma, yep, we got to do this for you.
Another what's her name for you? Mm-hmm.